the Dog Mom Knits podcast, episode 12. My name is Amanda, and you can find me on Instagram as Dog Mom Knits, on Ravelry as Dog Mom Knits 08, and we have an email address for this podcast, and that is dogmomknits@gmail.com. I live in coastal Virginia with my husband, Sean, and our three dogs, Bandit, Copper, and Finley. This is a podcast all about my crafty adventures and how knitting brings me joy. So thank you so much for tuning in and spending some of your time with me. All of my projects and my Ravelry project page, any shops and podcasts that I talk about will be linked in the drop box down below. But if I forget anything, please send me an email and I will happily tell you everything that I know. So it is July 12th. Happy Sock Week if you are participating in Sock Week with Natalie, who is Knitty Natty. I am, but more on that later because it's not going to plan. A little bit of housekeeping. Last Wednesday, I posted some bonus content. It was a vlog on my, the weekend that I spent doing the Zebra Yarns 4-day knit along. So if you haven't checked that out, please do. There's plenty of yarn content and lots of dog content. It is as much a vlog about the Zebra Yarns no long as it is about Bandit, Copper, and Finley and how they spend their time. So if you are at all interested in spending some time with the dogs, check out that vlog. And then last night, and I will have this video linked down below, last night, Sean and I, my husband and I, were interviewed by Donna, who is Handmade by Ying. We were interviewed here on YouTube. So again, I will link that video down below, but that was really fun. Sean was talking about his quilting and I was talking about my knitting. And so, yeah, if you want to know a little bit more about us, or get to know a little bit more about him if you hang out on my channel. That should be pretty fun. And again, I will have that linked down below. So I'm looking at my notes down here. I have my notebook with me because I need notes. But I have my notes. So I'm looking down to make sure that I didn't forget anything before I get into the knitting. And I did not. So the last time I podcasted, June wasn't quite over and I had one more goal. Sorry, I'm looking for the project in my pile of projects. I had one more goal for June and that was to finish my second Sweetheart sock, which is a pattern by Natalie, who is Knitty Natty. I had barely started. I think I was somewhere in the cuff. And I had like 2 days in the rest of June. And I really, really impressed myself. So I got all of the color work charts done. So again, this is the Sweetheart Socks by Knitty Natty. The yarn is, I think it's the Sweetheart set by Moonglow Yarn Co. I absolutely love it. I love, love, love the way it turned out. I don't necessarily love color work. I think I'm learning that about myself, that I'm not really a color work fan. I have a hard time tensioning my yarn in color work, and it just ends up stressing me out. I did the heel. And then there are pieces of color work through the foot. But I couldn't find the second skein of this white yarn, the main color. So I had to stop, even though I had gotten to the easy part. This is all I had left. Oh, wait, sorry. I knit until I had no white yarn left, basically. I was doing a little bit of like straightening up my yarn area. I can't do a lot still after my hysterectomy, which was a month ago on Thursday, but I was straightening up, like cleaning up, organizing just a little bit, and I found the other cake of yarn of the white. So I'm excited and ready to keep going. Those socks have been a crazy process. When I did the test knit with Natalie in January, I think I started those socks 4 times. Finley got a hold of them twice. I was knitting them at the end of June, and I found places where Finley had chewed it. So there's a bunch of extra ends. There's places where I'm going to have to go back and duplicate stitch to reinforce it. Those socks. They're a labor of love at this point. And I'm excited to have them done, but goodness me, the work that it has taken. The work. Just the work. So let me grab the bag, because I realized I didn't show the bag. This is a bag from the guy who sews, which is my husband. And I showed the Progress Keeper. If I can find the sock, there it is. The Progress Keeper that I have on it is from, I mean, is anybody surprised? But it is from 3xTheSea Designs. It was a pair. I got the heart and then the, wait, let me see if I can turn it correctly. Yes, the piece of candy. So I'm going to get through sock week. And then these are now one of my July goals. To get those done. And they're basically, it's just straight stockinette at this point with a little bit of striping in of the colors. So they should go pretty fast. So that is a June goal that's going to carry over to July. So let's check in on my July goals. So the first goal I had for myself was to participate in the Zebra Yarns 4-day knit along, and I completed it. So spoiler alert, if you haven't seen the vlog, this is one of the socks that I knit for the knit along. I used Zebra Yarns. The set is called the Red, White, and Blue. So I have the blue cuff and toe, and then the red and white striped. I did a combination of the String of Lights pattern by Sock Witchery and the Magic Heel Socks by the Autumn Acorn. And I have notes on my project page of kind of how many rows I did of each and how I combined the two patterns. And I tried not to give too much away because they're both paid for patterns. But yeah, it was a, this is for our foreign exchange student who is arriving in August. I wanted to add some ribbing to the sock because I really don't know the circumference of her foot. And I liked the idea of doing the Magic Heel sock just because I know her shoe size, but I mean, we haven't met her. So I wanted to be like, I wanted to give as much, what's the word? Flexibility. That's the word. I wanted to give as much flexibility to the sock as I could. So there's a lot of ribbing, a lot of texture to this sock. I did finish both. The other one is not on a sock blocker, so you can see it. But this is what it looks like off a sock blocker. And you can see when the two are next to each other, there's a lot of room in these two socks. So I'm excited to have that done. It was a part of a knit along. I've said that several times now. Sorry about that. Anna picked winners from the Instagram posts and I won. I won a skein of yarn from her. It is on its way here and I am super excited about it. So this was my first time knitting with Anna's yarn, Zebra Yarns. Obviously, it won't be the last because I have a skein of yarn coming to me, but if she does this knit along again next year over July 4th weekend, I think that's going to be, like, this is going to become a yearly thing for me where I knit my foreign exchange students Welcome to America socks from using Anna's yarn during her knit along. So that was really fun. So I got that done. Then my goal was to start and finish my July Desert Vista Dye Work socks between the end of the Zebra Yarns Knit Along and the beginning of Sock Week. That did not happen. I am still on sock number one of my Desert Vista Dye Work socks. My yarn this month is the Queen's Hats. So it's yarn colors based on the Queen of England. I love her. So this is what I have so far. I am using my pattern, which is the Road Trip socks. I'm just doing it on the front. So the back, you can just see the gloriousness of the stripes. But it's got this really cool, like, spiral texture to it. And I haven't knit a pair of Road Trip socks for myself. My pattern, my very first pattern, and all the socks that I have knit with it have been gift socks. So I thought it was time that I finally had a pair of Road Trip socks for myself. And I am using a Progress Keeper from 3 by the Sea Designs. And it is a little teacup, you know, the Queen's Hats and a teacup. It just felt like a good idea to me. This is the yarn. It's Desert Vista Dye Works, the Queen's Hats on her ZN base, which is her sparkle base. I'm going to get back to these after sock week as well, because obviously those need to be done in the month of July. These are in my Scaredy Cats bag from The Guy Who Sews. Again, my husband. Finley is outside announcing that there is some sort of intruder in her yard. It's probably a bird. Crazy birds. And Bandit is ready to go and offer his assistance. Take a sip of water. It is very, very hot here in coastal Virginia. It's in like the mid 90s, I think. Crazy off the charts humidity. So, yeah, I'm just staying inside and knitting because no. No, I don't need to go outside. Okay, so I'll go ahead and talk about my sock week socks because I'm on a little bit of a sock kick right now. So sock week is an 8-day knitting challenge hosted by Natalie, who is Knitty Natty. And I will have her channel and the Sock Week information linked down below. But the idea is that you set a challenge to knit a sock or to learn something new about sock knitting or knit a pair of socks or knit three socks or whatever. But it's an individual challenge. Each sock that you knit is entered into, you know, to win a prize. But I just love knitting socks and being part of a community of sock knitters. So I have my bag, again, from The Guy Who Sews, and I have my pin for this year. I don't know if it's going to, like, show up. From Allison of Stitchery & Co. And then the yarn that I am using is one of the sponsor yarns, and it's by, yes, Yarn Over New York. And the yarn color is Tiger's Eye Shark. My brain is like dead today. I have started, this is the now third time that I have started this sock. So I started it Sunday, which was the first day of the knit along. And I had a pattern idea that I was going to write, started it. Got a little bit of the way through it. The yarn is beautiful, but it's busy. There's a lot of color changes. And so the pattern was getting lost. So I ripped it out. And I started again Sunday night in the Stack of Books pattern by Sock Witchery. And I got halfway through the heel And again, just felt like I didn't like it. And I couldn't figure out why I didn't like it. So I just kept going. And then I figured out it was too busy. Even though it's a very basic pattern, it was too busy a pattern for too busy of yarn. So I ripped it out again last night and started again. And I'm doing a basic vanilla sock. So I've done the cuff. I have probably only like 10 rows of the leg, and I already like it better. So it's just going to, the yarn is so beautiful, and I got it on her Broadway base, which is her sparkle base. And there's just so much fun coloring and texture within the colors that it really just needed to be a vanilla sock. So this is take number 3 on my sock week socks, but now I feel like I'm gonna roll pretty good with it. Oh, I didn't mention my stitch marker. My progress keeper. I have a Baby Shark progress keeper from 3 by the Sea Designs. So take number 3. I feel like this is the one that's going to stick. And now I can keep going. My goal is to knit a pair of socks. So knit both socks this week. Now that I've restarted a few times, I'm not sure if I'm going to make it, but I'm going to try. So I look at that and I'm like, that's not a lot of knitting. Like, but it's because I don't really have a ton of sock knitting mojo right now. The knitting mojo that I have has been directed at a project that has been on the needles for 5 years. I put it in my bag from, this is from 3 by the Sea Designs. It was one of their Ukraine fundraiser bags because it is huge. I showed this on my Whips Parade, and I'm pretty sure I haven't shown it since, but this is my starting point shawl by Hohe Locatelli. No, I'm sorry, it's a wrap. My starting point wrap by Hohe Locatelli. And again, this thing is huge. So, sorry about that. So, I'm trying to hold it up for you guys. So this is half of it. This is the other half. And then, so the last time you guys saw it, I hadn't even finished this panel. So I finished piece number 1. That's all of this. Finished piece number 2. I then did this triangle to do the first half of the join between the two. And now I'm working on this side of the triangle, which will be the last. This is the last section that I have to knit. I definitely see the light at the end of the tunnel because the rows get shorter and shorter each time. It is a lot of garter stitch. So, yeah, 5 years in the making. I started this when she released it as a mystery knit along in 2017. This summer is going to be the summer that I finish it. I've declared it. It is huge. I mean, look at all. I think I looked it up on my project page the other day and it said it was like 2,000 yards of yarn or something like that. I don't even remember all of the yarn that I'm using, but I do have it all linked on my project page. It is a beautiful, I keep calling it a shawl. It is a beautiful wrap and I love it. And I'm going to love it when it is done. I will never knit this pattern again. It is just, it's huge. And it's just a lot. And yeah, again, I'm gonna love it when it's done, but I know this is gonna be one of those for me. It's gonna be a one and done. Like I'm not going to knit this again. It's too big. But it's almost done. Like, I'm working a little bit each day on it and making a lot of progress, which that was one of my goals for the summer, was to get this whip off the needles. And I think I'm going to do it. And that's really exciting to me. The other summer goal that I had for myself, if you watched my whips parade or my, I think it was my mid-June podcast, which would have been episode 10, I talked about kind of my summer goals, because when you're a teacher on summer vacation, you have a lot more time to knit. And so I was trying to, you know, I was hoping I could get through some of the bigger projects that I had on the needles. And I have some goals based on, you know, wanting to get that stuff done. And one of the projects that I wanted to work on quite a bit this summer was my Coziest Memory blanket. This is a pattern by Kemper Ray. Pretty sure I'm saying that right. I have lots and lots of scraps from projects. They're all fingering weight. And my goal is to put one square on a day. So this is the last square that you guys saw. I finished this row all the way out there. And then I have three squares of this next row. So when I started this summer, this was the last square that I had. So I have done, yeah, quite a bit. And I'm excited. I'm excited to see this one come together. I have not knit my square for today, but I chose my yarn. It is the Rags Fiber Arts Yellow Magic. I think that's going to look really pretty in a square. So that is coming along, and I'm excited to see more and more squares of that come together. So that's it for goals for July so far. So 2 weeks left in July. I'm still working towards the goal of not having any sock whips by the end of the summer. So that means that I need to, this is going to sound really daunting, I need to finish my Sweetheart socks. I need to finish my Sock Week socks. I need to finish my Desert Vista Dyework socks. I also have two other sock whips that I picked for the month of July, which are the, what I'm calling my bestie socks, which is a sock that I'm knitting with my best friend, and to finish the second of my Perfect Fit socks, which is a class that was taught by Knitty Natty Natalie. So those are the socks that I want to finish in July. I also want to finish my starting point, which I think I can do, and get back to and put quite a bit of work in my summer lounging tee by Hohe Locatelli. I could feel like I need to take a deep breath just saying that out loud. It's a lot of plans for the month of July. A lot of things that I want done. So, cross your fingers for me. So I'm looking at my notes. That's all the knitting. So I'm gonna take a sip of water. And I'll talk through my acquisitions. Do not have very many acquisitions this time, which I'm sure my husband is grateful for. I had quite a few last time, so I think I just needed to take a deep breath. The first acquisition is my Yarnable box. I get this subscription every month, and I absolutely love it. The theme this month was, hold on, sorry about this. I was not ready. The theme this month was picnic basket, and it came with a little cutlery set and some napkins, some reusable napkins, and a recipe, which was so much fun. And then the yarn, so beautiful. is this beautiful tonal red. And it is called Picnic Basket. And it is on her 8515 plush sock base. So, yeah. No idea if that's going to be socks or something else. But it is beautiful. It's really, really pretty. And I'm super excited about it. So, that was my first acquisition. And then my second acquisition was the... So, Three by the Sea Designs, who, if you watch this podcast, you know I am obsessed with their stitch markers. Kim has started dyeing yarn, and they released their first ever sock set. It's called She Sells Seashells. And so, of course, I had to get it. Plus, it's stunning, so I had to get it. But that's their logo. And then there is the yarn. I still have it in its packaging, so I'm sorry for the glare. But it is... She Sells Seashells is the main color, and then Starfish is the mini, because I got the sock set. I just think this is so beautiful, and I cannot wait to see this knit up. I've seen Kim working on it, and it is just beautiful. It's so beautiful. So I'm excited for this one. I've got to get through my other stuff, and then I'll probably be full on Team Chaos and counting and casting on all of the socks after I get all of my whips off the needles. If I can get all my, no, not if I can, I can. And that's it. I have only been talking to the camera for 27 minutes. One today. I'll do a little bit of a life update, and then that'll be it. So, I saw my doctor a week and a half ago. I did. I think I mentioned it earlier. I had surgery about a month ago. I had a partial hysterectomy, and I saw my doctor like a week and a half ago, and she was very happy with my progress. She said I need to keep with the restrictions. So I can't really do anything around the house. I can't lift anything that's more than 10 pounds. I can go for walks around the neighborhood. They have to be short walks. And I have to walk, you know, if I take the dogs, it has to be a dog that doesn't pull on their leash. So basically that means I can only walk Bandit. But that's been good to at least get out of the house a little bit. It is weird not being able to do any housework, because usually over the summer is when I do a lot of like the cleaning that I just do not have time to do during the school year. And so it's weird not being able to do that. I feel like I have to do that. I need to, you know, this is my time to clean and organize and throw away and donate to Goodwill. And I'm like, but I can't. And so that just feels a little strange to me. I don't know why. But all is well. I go back to see my doctor at the beginning of August. She said if everything still looks good, then she'll release me from the restrictions. So that'll give us a couple of weeks before our foreign exchange student arrives to hopefully get the stuff done around the house that I want to. So I talked about it on the last podcast, but I went back to reading the Joanne Fluke Hannah Swenson series. I finished book 25, which was Coconut Layer Cake, and I'm now reading book 26, which is Christmas Cupcake Murder. But I'm confused because book 26, even though it's like, you know, number 25, number 26, you'd think that 26 would be after 25, but it's not. It's like years before. And I don't get it. This happened on book 24, I'm pretty sure, as well, or 23 or something like that. I don't understand the jumping around of the timeline unless I'm not reading them in order, but I'm reading them by the numbers. So like, I just finished 25, so I started 26. I still enjoy it. I still like the series. I'm just confused by how it seems like I'm reading them out of order, even though I'm reading them in numerical order. I finished Rosalian Isles on HBO Max. I did find an Angie Harmon series from earlier. It's like from 2006, I think it was. It was called Women's Murder Club. And I watched that. That was on Tubi. It wasn't great. It wasn't my favorite. Not gonna lie. I watched Hell's Kitchen season 20 on Hulu. And then I finished watching Top Chef Just Desserts season 1, which was on Tubi. So I've been sitting and knitting a lot on my Starting Point shawl and watching quite a bit of TV and then reading quite a bit in the evenings. So that's been really fun. I mean, it's summer vacation. That's what I do. I knit and I watch TV and then I go to bed early and I read half the night. So yeah, I guess this is just going to be a short video today. I don't know. I don't know what happened there. Thank you so much for tuning in. I feel like I'm really disjointed today. Like I said, we live in coastal Virginia. It's really hot. I feel like my allergies are going crazy. I've got like a touch of a migraine today. Sean went outside looking for Finley and she's sleeping on the couch under the fan. I've got a little bit of a migraine today. I'm taking medicine, but it's not, you know, it's what it is. It's supposed to be really, really hot today and then storm tomorrow. So that's probably where it's coming from. So if I had a little less energy than normal today, I apologize. Hopefully next time I will be back to my usual self. And hopefully next time I will have some completed projects to show you. Fingers crossed. I will have finished objects. I will have some of these goals checked off. Oh, fingers crossed. All right. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Like and subscribe if you liked what you saw. If you haven't already subscribed, leave me a comment down below. Let me know how you're doing with your knitting goals this summer. Mine are a little all over the place right now. So let me know down below how you're doing. And I hope you have a great 2 weeks. I hope that whatever you are knitting brings you lots and lots of joy. And I will see you back here in 2 weeks for episode 13. Bye.